1789 году и основали село Нижняя Хортица. Они успешно занимались как земледелием, так и были отличными умельцами. Но они разделили судьбу всех меннонитов, которые поселились здесь, на Украине, от начала поселения и до 1943 года.
The Mennonites were invited to the Russian Empire by Empress Catherine II to develop new southern lands. Mennonites were granted privileges, land, and religious freedom. This became the basis of their economic success. The Mennonites were consistent in their religious pacifism. They strictly followed the traditions of the Christian faith. However, they didn't reject innovations. Johann Kornis was a famous leader who led the Mennonite Agricultural Union. In the second part of the 19th century, the colonies had the highest level of economic freedom and an environment beneficial to their business and culture. In the Russian Empire and the Soviet Union, the Mennonites experienced difficulties. Russian nationalism disliked them for speaking German and keeping their faith. During the First World War and the Bolshevik Revolution of 1917, the Mennonites were called up for military service and treated as enemies. The Makhno Army attacked and destroyed many Mennonite colonies. Resilience seemed to be the only way to survive.
Трудности и послевоенный голод активизировали деятельность общин. Меннониты объединились в организацию «Союз потомков голландских выходцев». Кроме хозяйственной деятельности, Союз также поддерживал и иммиграционную программу. И до 1928 года СССР покинуло 17 тысяч меннонитов.
During the years of the Great Stalin Terror in 1937 and 38, more than 21,000 people were arrested and 18,000 were sentenced to death. In 1943, most of the Mennonites left the territory of the USSR together with the Wehrmacht troops. Many moved to North America. The rest of the refugees were deported to remote areas of the USSR when the Soviet army came to Europe.
И после смерти Сталина меннониты не могли вернуться на родину. И лишь с началом перестройки они воспользовались возможностями эмиграции в Германию, где их ожидала долгожданная религиозная и политическая свобода.
Under the perestroika, the revival of the Mennonite communities started at the territory of the former Chortysa and Molochna colonies. Today, Ukrainian Mennonites don't have to hide their worldview. Their attitude of resilience gave them strength to stay faithful to their beliefs. They feel connected to their country, doing useful things, and society recognizes their goodwill. They feel connected to the Mennonite communities worldwide and want to make the world a better place for everyone.